So, to explain a couple things for the people who actually care, I am in a transitional phase. I'll drop a little time stamp to skip to get to the actual video for whatever video I put this in front of. But as far as like my uploading and stuff like that, I try to be consistent, but as of right now, I'm in a transitional phase. I just got the Neo into a storage unit, the new storage unit that the S14 is supposed to go into. So that's one thing. The second thing is that I just picked up a trans, CD09 trans that I'm going to be using for the Neo swap. Hopefully I can put a clip right here. And so that's also in the storage unit. I still got to move everything from the first storage unit that you guys have seen to the new one. And in the process of me getting all, you know, ready to do that, the Lexus that I was using as a daily has broken down. I'm in the works of selling it right now. So that's been happening, but outside of that, I don't have a car to get there, so it's been kind of hard to move around and stuff. But I have been collecting parts for the Neo. I do have the Mishimoto thermostat that I'm going to use on there. But the bigger thing that I have at the ready is this one. So, for those that don't know what this is a RB25 Neo drop-in link standalone ECU. So, this one literally fits inside the stock ECU housing. Link designed it that way for California visual emissions tests. And, I mean, it's a link ECU, so it's pretty good. You know, most recommended ECU that I've heard about. And people say that you get the most bang for your buck. So I have been collecting parts. I got the ECU, I got the trans, I got the thermostat all ready to, you know, go towards the Neo. I'm going to be ordering my manifold, turbo manifold for the Neo as well, and kind of going over that. So hopefully this transitional period gets worked out pretty soon, and I can, you know, start going to the storage unit and doing work on the car and everything like that again more frequently. Last time that I was on the car was the next day after the last video I posted, where I was able to back it out and see it in the light. I'll post that clip right here. It's pretty much the car.
This is the first time I'm seeing it in the light. I mean, it does have to be wet sanded. But, I mean, it's decent. I can definitely tell that the color has a different kind of consistency here than it does here. It's like way more glossy on the fenders, so I probably got to do more coats and stuff on that. But it is all the same color, technically speaking. So, in a later date, I'll probably switch it out, or, you know, do it properly, or, you know, go from there. But it's pretty much where it's at. The new power steering, I might have spoke too soon. That's power steering. I don't see it coming from anywhere. Oh, it might be coming from the actual reservoir. So that means the rack is holding up. That's good. And it's not nearly as big either. But just wanted to show you guys pretty much the progress of the car, how it is. Paint is always susceptible to be changed. There's some stuff I want to do. Obviously want to get rid of that body line gap right there and work on something. I still got plans for the rear fenders. There's more to that. So I'm gonna make that better. But this is pretty much how she is now. So There's that. But yeah, decent. Still got the super fat I think these are 245s and 355s, so it still like looks like it's gonna kick some ass. I just can't wait till I'm able to achieve the stance I actually want.
But since that point in time, I haven't been back to the garage because that's when the Lexus started quitting. So we'll see how this goes. But I did want to just throw this in front of the video for the 100 subscribers that I have now. Glad that I finally reached 100. But I did want to throw this in for the subscribers I got that, you know, might be wondering anything. I don't know. So I'm pretty much using this as an update video. I've decided that I'm going to make this its own video. And then I'm going to do the install video of the two parts that I'm going to install separately. I don't want to be one of those YouTubers that's like, you know, brand new rims for the car and then spend 15 minutes in the front of the video doing like vlog shit. And then the last 3 minutes of the video was actually putting the rims on. So this is pretty much just like a, you know, moving the 240 to the new storage unit and setting all that up. Finally got out here. Was able to use my dad's truck since the daily's gone. Just cleaned up this side of the storage unit. I still got this side to go. And all of that is pretty much garbage from me. You know, this is all parts that I've taken off the car when I replaced it. Paint that I've used, you know, pretty much from here back is all garbage. So that's all going out. I just got this stuff to worry about. I want to set those shelves up in the new storage unit. I got to put these wheels on the 240 and take the wide ones off so they can fit on a trailer. And also, this is garbage. I'm actually getting rid of my drone because I broke it, and it's actually a really cheap drone. So I'm getting rid of that. Side skirts that I made, stock spoiler. So the weird thingies that I made as well, getting rid of that. I'm probably gonna go ahead and trash the s14.5 metal fenders and this s15 rocket bunny kit, or rocket bunny front bumper, as well as this rocket bunny splitter, because I don't need it and I don't think anybody's gonna buy that. So those will be going in the trash. These wheels were the ones that came on the Lexus. I took them off and replaced them with these that were on the 240 because of the tread. So the Lexus has those two still on it, and I got these. I'm gonna just throw these on the S14 for the time being so I get on the trailer. But one of my buddies wants the other remaining two wheels. I actually sold the Lexus to one of my buddies, so he wants the remaining two S14 ones. So these might be getting sold after the S14 is moved. And then I might just sell these for like $50 or some shit. I don't know. But yeah, so that's pretty much what the progress is. I'm waiting on my guy to get here with the trailer. So far, I've only filled up this much of stuff in the 240. And in my dad's truck, I filled up this much of stuff with my tools. I'm kind of trying to keep it tools in the truck, everything else in the 240. So with the exception of electrical stuff, so that's why all the fluids, the paint, and all that's there. And then it's the electrical stuff and the parts, if I can help it. So that's what I'm going for. I'm probably just going to cut to when we are loading the car onto the trailer, and then we'll go from there. Hopefully I can get everything to the new storage unit today so I can stop paying for this one and actually have a big space, like twice the size of this space, to work on. So I have the car pretty much right here, but it'll be literally this much space, like the length of this car, in front of it, which is where I'm gonna be building the engine and everything like that. I'm also going to be meeting up with a buddy, a local buddy, possibly getting the shifter relocation for the CD09 transmission that you guys are going to see as well. So I got a lot planned for today. I'm also going to be taking these taillights because I'm going to start my own custom taillight design that I'm going to be doing since I just picked up a 3D printer. So yeah, I got a lot of stuff. I got a lot of stuff that I've been working on in the midst of me not being able to move around since I sold the car. So we're going to see how this goes.
All right, so I got pretty much all the garbage and stuff out. It's pretty clean, pretty clean. The only things I still got are like the big pieces that I can't fit in the truck right now. So the splitter, the bumper, the fenders, and this spoiler. Everything else is coming with. Right now I'm gonna take a quick lunch break. I got a hot dog and some stuff because I'm still waiting on the guys that's coming to tow the 240. So I'm gonna just eat that real quick, and then after that throw the wheels on and probably take off the front bumper, maybe the front fenders as well, just to make it easier so to clear and stuff like that. Definitely don't want to damage this stuff. And yeah, from that point on, looks like we'll be good. So we got the last piece of this move, the front bumper, in. We are saying goodbye to this storage unit. So looks like this whole move is pretty much done. Got the 240 in, as you saw. Got everything for the most part set up. It looks so bad with these stock wheels. But yeah, for the most part, I got everything set up. I love the new amount of space. The old storage unit used to come to about right here. Then you'd have the car and then the space. But with this new one, I have all of this to work with. And the Neo gets to see the 20 for the first time. 20 gets to see the Neo for the first time. I've organized all my tools. I got like jacks and stands right there. All the sockets and stuff are up here. Fluids at the bottom. Hammers at the top, power tools at the top, wrenches and drill bits, and screwdrivers here, electrical and kind of like miscellaneous special stuff right there, like the Allen wrenches, wire brushes, that stuff. On the bottom is not really classified for anything. I just got the sandpaper there, the torches, you know, some cables. This is mostly empty. Got some miscellaneous parts right here that I got to install at some point. So I got that right there. I also got parts right here. So this is where the fuel pump that will go back in is. The other trunk latch, the shift, the boots for the tie rod ends and that stuff. Whoever buys the RB20 is going to get this RB20 license plate thing because I'm not going to need it on the house. This is the CD09 trans that I have yet to show on video. So
at the end of this video, actually, when I leave here, I'm going to go to get a shifter bracket, the GK Touch shifter relocation bracket for this. I already have the S14 to CD09 clutch line, so this is almost, and this is making progress. Still need to get the adapter plate with the flywheel, give me a clutch setup. You, with the adapter plate that I'm going to be getting, you run 350Z clutches. This CD09 came with the 350Z clutch, so if I want it to be cheap, I could just use that. It does still have meat on it, but I'm not going to be cheap. It's built for, you know, this when it goes in the car should be making 400 horsepower. So I'm not going to use a stock clutch because it's just going to be slipping. But there's that. Here's the Neo that I showed a while ago. The next video I make is going to be putting the G4 drop-in standalone link ECU, which should fit in the stock ECU housing. And so it'll pretty much just be like disassembling this and all that stuff. I want to knock that out and then clear this off because I want to strap the transmission to the top of this. That way it'll be easier to work on. Unfortunately, I do have to break into my own toolbox. This is from when I was at school at SIU. And I have since lost the keys and all these drawers are locked. Majority of the tools I use are these. I think in here are like the punches, like picks, and other miscellaneous like small stuff in there. So I will break into that probably tomorrow. But yeah, so that's what I'm probably going to be recording tomorrow. The link ECU install. I may install the thermostat, not sure. I'm going to put this together because I'm going to need it. I mean, I don't need it as of right now, but I will need it. So yeah, it's those three things. This is the final rest in place for the 240. Well, not the final rest in place, but the rest in place before the Neo goes in. This thing probably won't move until it's time to go put it on the dyno tune. These wheels are also not going to be getting put on it until it's time to go for the dyno tune because it's swapping time, man. Yeah. But, yeah, so we're going to go get this GK Touch bracket. Oh, also, the guy that was towing the car let me have this. This was actually something that I was looking forward to getting. I was going to get an Origin one. I'm not sure if this is an eBay one or not. I'm going to paint match it. It's not going to stay black. But, yeah. It's not, it doesn't have any tape on it or anything, so it's not trying to, like, fit. But it does fit pretty decent when it's, like, actually held down by the tape. So he gave me that for free, which is cool. I gave him my S15 front bumper and my Rocket Bunny splitter. So, you know, just 240 guys doing things. So that's another thing that I'm kind of excited about. But yeah, like I'm really feeling this. Like this is the most space I've ever had to work on a car and stuff. I might give myself like a little chair or something. I got a speaker here that I'll just be charging. It has light, unlike the last storage unit, and it's directly over the engine bay too, so that's good. And one thing about mines, it's good but bad. It's bad for public storage but good for me. They have these like little light switches on the outside, that one right there, and these are pretty much what turn the lights on. So you really pop this up, you turn it to 30, which is 30 minutes, and then it ticks down and then the light comes back off, so light stays on for 30 minutes. But the one that controls my unit is stuck at 30 minutes. So I have 24/7 light. I ain't telling nobody. Public storage, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. Don't fix it. I need it. I still may or may not get like some little LED lights here and there to just kind of hook up for if I'm not working in this area and I'm over here. It's a little dark over here, but we'll see. We'll see how this all goes. You know, for the majority, I'm really excited about this step forward as I get reliable transportation back and forth to this storage unit. I'll make more videos because like I said, I sold the daily, so getting here and doing stuff is going to be a little bit hard. However, what I'm mostly doing is collecting parts for the Neo. I already ordered my exhaust manifold. The turbo will be next, and then there'll be more CD09 stuff. so that when I do come, I'm able to do a lot of stuff. But one thing that I'm going to do tomorrow is I'm going to stop procrastinating and start my custom taillight build. So tomorrow, I'm taking the taillights out and I'm taking them home with me. And I'm going to start doing a custom taillight build. Something else that I just picked up yesterday is a 3D printer, which will come in handy for this custom taillight build that I am going to be doing. I'm excited for that. You guys will see that. That's going to be dope. A lot more things to come, but you kind of get the ideas. This is what I mean by the transitional phase. So, without further ado, we're going to go get this GK Tech bracket. And that'll be that. I may end the video here because it's not really too much of a thing. I mean, unless you want to see the guy who I'm getting it from. He's putting the LS in his S13. Really local guy to Chicago. A lot of people might know him. So I may or may not include that in here. So, but if I don't, it'll be till next time, which is tomorrow. And yeah, you know, like, subscribe.